Continuing with the analysis part, this is the part two. So which of the following was the latest inclusion in Intangible Girl? So this was quite in news. Garba dance was quite in news to around the Durga Puja period. So this could have been solved and was solved. Now India is a member of national. Now this I had solved in the previous 5 months, but I did not revise. So in the exam hall, I was not quite sure and I used a very stupid logic over here. And then neither one, neither two. And also it was some kind of a PYK or something. Excuse me. Moving on, consider the following statement, like there are no parables, absolutely wrong statement, and the Upanishads were controlled, composed quite correct. So this was solved, easy question. And again, here we did not this was an expected question, like they always ask Rayet's Virus system and Malwadi system and permanent settlement. So we did a stupid mistake over here again, and then again over here. So history, again a mistake. This was a very difficult question for me and I did avoid it. Then we had this easy question, should have been attempted, and we did attempt it. And then we had the economy section, from where there were some easy questions and some complex questions. Now this we have marked, and then in question number 52, this is a controversial question in the sense that the Hindi translation was quite the opposite of the first statement. Like the statement which is given over here and the statement in the Hindi section, it was quite the opposite. So this question might be dropped, although I have made it marked it correct. Now here the options were I don't know if I have marked it or not in my question paper, like OMR sheet, but nevertheless, moving on, 50 number question. We have marked one, that is in the first round itself. Now 49, we have marked, this was a very factual question. We kind of did to cover here, like, and we have marked B. So moving on, 48 number, we have metaverse, and then 47, we had marked only two, considering that a farmer's plow is a fixed capital, not a working capital, and petrol can be considered as a working capital, not a fixed capital. But then it can, it's always a fixed capital. Now, consider the following materials. Sustainable, it was quite a straightforward question, and also it was made easy by the use of word can, so I was able to pick on that. Now here we have the economic activities and the sectors. Now here mineral exploration is given, however mining is in primary sector, but mineral exploration is either tertiary or quaternary. So there's quite confusion in this one, but most of the coaching institutes have marked mineral explorations as primary, but let's see. Nevertheless, exchange traded funds, currency swap. Now financial instrument, it was quite easy. Now 43 number question, corporate bonds and government securities. Yeah, it was also a straightforward question. Now we had 42 number questions. Now this is interesting because in 42 number question and 40 number questions, they both are talking about the securities market and the money market. But here I have made a blunder that stock exchanges can offer separate trading platform for debts. This they can do, of course, because securities like bond market, of course, is with SEBI. So they can regulate, but money market is with RBI. So using this logic, I marked this correct, but using the same logic, I have marked over here this one as incorrect because I don't know, exam pressure and whatnot. Now over here, 39 number question, membrane bioreactors. I was confused between wastewater treatment and drug delivery nanotechnology, but then I marked it as vaccine production technology. I don't know why. Now recently the term pumped storage hydropower. Hydropower is directly connected with energy, so it was quite easy. Now fuel cell, direct question, water vapor is an exhaust. Now in what are the followings are hydrological gels used? It was a difficult question in the sense that R is used because and then we have marked, I don't know if we have marked D or not, but let's see. Then this was a straightforward question with fifth generation. We knew the answer, so we were able to mark it. And then we had this radar question. It was a risky question. I don't know how to. And then over here, I was confused between the first option and the second option. However, in the final selection, I marked B. I don't know why. I should have trusted my guts, because I was able to narrow it down to 50% chances. Like nitric oxide is the correct answer over here. But nevertheless, moving on, 32 was an easy, straightforward question. I was able to mark it. And then we have RTG, that is radioisotope thermoelectric generators. Now over here, had we been able to recall that reactors, miniature reactors, are between 5 megawatts to 300 megawatts, we would have been able to solve this question, but we did not solve, stupidity and whatnot. And then cashew and papaya, they both are Portuguese, so native to India, only one. Then we had this poisonous, so it was okay. 28, we had this information, we had seen this in a reel, so that was there. And then 27, we have distributed energy resources, quite straightforward. Then we had 26, we went with the convention that A is correct. I was confused between A and D, but then I selected A. Then we have 25. Now this was a question where I should have used my latent information and knowledge, wherein lions kill the cubs of the existing lions, and then first they fight off the lions, existing lions, and then they kill the cubs and then they mate. So had I used that information, one would have been eliminated and we would have arrived at option B, but we did not solve it. It was in our knowledge base, so we should have been able, this question should have been avoided because it was very factual, and I don't know if I have marked D or not, but then 23, it should have been avoided and we did avoid. In 22 number question, now it was very straightforward question. 21 also very straightforward question. 20, it is a controversial question given the amendment. Then in 19, we had the monocotyledons and bicotyledons. Now in 18 number, we had parasitoids. Now parasitoids exist in almost all the species, so according to that, it should be all 5, but I don't know. There are varying answer keys. Now a straightforward question, then we had this again, a straightforward. Now geography was quite straightforward, and I think 11 number was factual question had we known, and then again 10 number was a very factual question, 9 number was a very factual question. Apart from these, rest of again, yes, 8 number here, a trap was set and we fell into that trap. We should have no revised not by plan. It was quite in news, very famous in 2022-23 towards the start of Ukraine-Russia war. And then rest of the 5 questions, the starting 5 questions, they were quite straightforward and easy. So that was there, yes. So this is it. We could have solved. We have a kind of marked all our pitfalls. We could have solved the question paper. We should have trusted our gut feeling. And then we should have revised factual subjects like history, certain polity from the Bayer Act, and history sections from modern history and ancient history also. Nevertheless, overall, this is it. So we are winding up prelims 2024. And we'll be revising with all the materials that we have left. Ciao.